classic Canadian song from a classic Canadian rocker. Tom Cochrane's Highway of Life has led him to a new album.
I was standing with myself, didn't want nobody else at the time to tell me what to take and what to leave.
Take It Home is all about songs that reflect on the journey he's been on and his influences along the way.
A lot of it was Southern blues, rock and roll, folk music that not just me, but a lot of Canadians, and we create wonderful hybrids with our Canadian experience and our Celtic and Gaelic influences in our music that a lot of us grew up with. And you combine that with some of those Southern influences. So this record sort of is a tribute to that as well, so to a lot of those influences.
But it isn't just music that's influenced and inspired Tom Cochrane.
My heroes when I was a kid were people like Edward R. Murrow and Schlesinger, Peter Jennings,
really?
Great Canadian broadcaster. Zosky was a sort of a correspondent when he started out.
So inspired by those noted journalists that Cochrane decided he wanted to attend Ryerson Polytechnic Institute to study journalism.
That was my exit strategy if the music thing didn't pan out, because I wasn't going to be a victim of the music side of it. And I remember, you know, there's one song on the record called The Ones That I've Known. First verse is about Rosa Parks, civil rights. Last verse is about Terry Fox, and it's about their struggle for freedom. They're both struggles for freedom, completely disparate. One's civil rights and dignity, and the other one is freedom against the disease.
It was, in fact, an encounter with Terry Fox during his marathon of hope that changed Cochrane's life. While riding with bandmates, slogging away from gig to gig, they got stuck on the highway.
And I was going to quit. I was going to quit music. And I remember that one day, and it changed my life. It changed the course of where I was going, because I woke up and I go, why has traffic stopped? We're out in the middle of nowhere. We're just outside of Thunder Bay. And this police car goes by, and the rain's streaming down the window, and then this one-legged boy runs by, and you couldn't tell what was tears and what was water running down his face, and he was ashen looking, and obviously in pain, but there was incredible courage.
The cancer had spread, and now I've got cancer in my lungs, and we got to go home and try and do some more treatment.
And I thought, how tough can this be, what I'm doing? You know, I'm making music. And it kind of changed the way I looked at it. So it kind of forced me to keep going, you know, and keep going ahead, watching him and knowing that was his last day, finding out later that was his last day. It was a very powerful experience.
And it set Cochrane on a path to musical success, first as a solo artist, then with his band Red Rider. He was nominated for a Grammy, won countless other musical awards, including Junos, has been inducted into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame, and been named an Officer of the Order of Canada. It all helped Cochrane resist any temptation to take his talents south of the border.
What kept you here?
We've had success, tons of success in the States, and so on and so forth. But yeah, back when we were starting out as Red Rider, we were unabashedly Canadian. Like, we used to talk about it, whereas a lot of people back then, a lot of artists back then would avoid the subject, you know? And I didn't understand why. I was very proud to be Canadian. And I like to think that if I made a contribution, one of the main ones would be I set the table for bands like Tragically Hip and Blue Rodeo and that, to have a strong base in Canada, and this is, and be proud of that, and be self-sustaining in Canada. That didn't exist.
Making making hits out of songs that told the story of Canadians, like the chart-topping Big League, a Canadian tale that became universal.
People say, well, what's the song you're most proud of? And it always seems to get back to that song because it's a Canadian experience that still resonates with other people. It was an experience that was written from my personal experience as a Canadian and a hockey player whose dad and mom drove him to hockey practices and all that, and then the true story, which is more tragic than that, but it's helped people interpret it everywhere.
Decades of singing and crafting the story of a country he loves.
My dad kind of instilled that in me. He was a bush pilot from northern Manitoba and kind of a woodsman, you know. And so I was always really proud of my heritage. And I thought, there's nothing more magical than Canada. I mean, why should we be shy about being proud of that?
That dream of becoming a journalist may have been set aside in favor of telling a good Canadian story through song.
Or you might have been Peter Mansbridge instead of Peter Mansbridge.
Well, I'm not as good looking as Peter. It wouldn't have worked out.